Second time in Tennessee history, you get two grand slams in one game. I guess how nice was it to get that offense in the first game?
Well, I didn't know that, but that's good, you know, because our mantra is offense. And right now, you know, with our defense struggling a little bit and sometimes our pitching struggling, we need the offense to score a lot of runs. So I just told them in the last inning before they went up to bat, it's getting really cold out here and we're losing a lot of the fans, and it'd be nice if we could pick up two runs. And they did it, so my hat's off to them.
How nice was it to see Scarlett send that one out with the way she's kind of struggled to start the season?
It was really neat. You know, she had 10 home runs last year. You know, she's a pretty good kid, but like you said, she's been struggling this year. It's just a battle. You know, everything is a battle. You know, we look back and we've talked before about losing five games to top teams and three of those by one run. And I think we're starting to gel, but I'm sure everybody else is starting to gel. That's the whole reason for this pre-conference schedule.
So you got a couple strong outings from two freshman pitchers. How good is it to maybe see that third or fourth option kind of start to develop?
Well, it's really good. We're going to need them. I mean, you know, we're going to be a pitch-by-committee club, and we've talked about that before, and we're going to need all of them doing their thing. And our goal was to rest Aaron today because, you know, St. John's was their conference champion, and they went to the regionals last year. Birmingham, Alabama Birmingham, is always a good club. So, you know, I had not seen Wisconsin Green Bay before, but either way, we're going to play three more games in this tournament and see what happens.
Lexi didn't start that second game, came in and got a couple big hits. Were you planning to go to her late, or was that just kind of something?
Well, I was going to try to rest her too, because she got banged up down at Alabama when it's kind of ironic when she and Abby Lockman collided on that play down there. And so I try to give her as much rest as I can give her. And I was going to sit her the whole game, but then Abby got banged up at home plate. So, you know, I had to put her back in. So
13 of your 20 runs came from the 8-9 spot in the lineup. What does that mean for your offense to get that kind of production that late in the lineup?
Well, you know, it means a lot, but we kind of do that on purpose because Rainey Gaffin has been really good in relief for us. And when we put in another player and we take her to pitch, we'd rather have the other player be a defoe, that's a person that doesn't bat, you know, so we can just flip the 9-10 spot. Because, like, let's say if Bria Bush starts pitching, she's in the 10 spot, so she doesn't bat. So if we want to keep Rainey's bat in the order, we pull her out of the outfield or wherever she's playing, we just put a defensive player in the 10 slot. And that's what everybody else does too. So that's why Rainey's batting high in the order. I think Rainey could bat in the middle of any lineup in our conference.
Two grand slams in the first game, then in the second game, a lot of walks, a lot of hit by pitches. I guess how nice was it to kind of get that different type of offense in the second game?
Well, it was good, but that was by design. And again, we've learned through struggles in our conference, and our conference has a lot of good teams in it, that pitch selection is the key. You know, it's really the whole key to hitting. You can't get up there and swing at balls over your head or in the dirt or something like that. So if you're really patient at bat, you're generally going to get a good pitch to hit.
Couple more questions, guys.
When you've got a lot of young players, is it kind of hard to stress that patience?
It is. You know, it is. Obviously, the older players do it better, you know, all the way through the league. The older players are more patient and have learned how to get walks and get hit and, you know, get on. So that's great.
Ralph, how much different is it to play on a cold day like today?
Well, it was pretty hard to play on a day like today because I was cold. I know that. And I'm not even running or anything like that. And I've got a big jacket on. So, but tomorrow's supposed to be warmer. It's supposed to be in the 60s. But it's hard, you know. And I take my hat off to all the teams over here because they did a good job.
Thanks, guys.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.